Sometimes when evaluating integrals using integration by parts, we will end up with a new integral that is identical to the integral that we started with. For example, let's look at the integral of e to the x times the cosine of x dx. Now, the first thing we need to do is figure out our u substitution. We could just try that by trial and error, but we also have the acronym LIATE, which represents, again, in order, logarithms, inverse trig, algebra, trig, and exponential. In this case, we have an exponential and a trig, so u will be the trig function, u equals cosine x. The result then is du is a negative sine x dx. That means that dv is equal to the e to the x dx, and the antiderivative of that will give us v equal e to the x. Using integration by parts, this gives us u, which is the cosine of x, times v, which is e to the x, minus the integral of v, which is e to the x, times du, which is a negative sine x dx. Now notice we didn't get too far with this. We started with an e to the x and a trig function, and we've ended up with another integral of an e to the x with the trig function. So we haven't really improved things, but we'll try and keep going. Also notice we have a double negative here, the negative integral and the negative sign, which will turn into a plus. So this equals e to the x cosine x. Again, we have the double negative. So plus the integral of e to the x sine x dx. And so we're going to have to do integration by parts with the second integral as well. So again, we have a trig and an exponential, which means u is going to be the trig function. So u equals sine x. Du is equal to cosine x dx. Dv will equal, same thing again, e to the x dx. So v is equal to e to the x. So all of this is equal to e to the x cosine x plus, open a big parenthesis here, do the integration by parts again, the u, which is sine x, times the v, which is e to the x, minus the integral of v, which is e to the x, times du, which is cosine x dx. And then we can close that whole parenthesis. This is equal then to e to the x cosine x plus e to the x sine x minus the integral e to the x cosine x dx. Which again, notice that this new integral that we have here is identical to the integral that we started with. And if we follow our equalities all the way through, our original integral is equal to this whole statement that we have. So that gives us an equation, which that equation is the integral of e to the x cosine x dx will be equal to e to the x cosine x plus e to the x sine x minus the integral of e to the x cosine x dx. So on both sides of the equation, we have an integral of e to the x cosine x dx on both the left side and on the right side. On the right side, it's being subtracted. So if we would add it back to the left side, when you add something to itself, you end up getting two of them. So now on the left side of our equation, we'll have 2 times the integral of e to the x cosine x dx is equal to e to the x cosine x plus e to the x sine x. And we're trying to solve for our integral, so we're going to take everything and divide both sides by 2. So by solving this equation, we get the integral of e to the x cosine x dx will be equal to the quantity e to the x cosine x plus e to the x sine x all over 2. So that's a method that we can use to solve the original integral.